A lady's Fabergé watch has won a prestigious Swiss watchmaker's industry prize, the Grand Prix de l'Horlogerie de Genève, pretty much the Oscars of the watch world. Ian Harebottle, CEO of Gemfields, which owns luxury business Fabergé, is on the line now. Ian, congratulations. This is rather an honour, isn't it?
Oh, absolutely. I think you can hear by my voice I'm ecstatic. You know, the team has worked really hard. And many companies will, you know, producing fine watches for many, many years and never get a chance to get an award of this nature. So for a company like Gemfields and Fabergé that's quite new in luxury and specifically in the watch scene, I think it's incredible.
I mean, it's less than 2 years, isn't it, since the watch team has been established. Are things ticking along, excuse the pun, at a nice pace for you then?
I love the pun. I think it's great. And yes, you know, the CEO of a business in this sector, when you see the potential and you've got such great products, such a great brand, such an incredible team, one's always ambitious and you're always impatient. And certainly we'd always want to be, you know, a whole lot further ahead, a whole lot quicker. But in reality, if you catch your breath and you look back and see how Gemfields and Fabergé are doing, I have to say I'm very proud of my team. We're doing incredibly well and really doing some stuff that'll see us well way into the future.
It is a competitive market, though. I mean, look, we've got all of this wearable technology and the Apple Watch, which has piqued consumers' interest. Tell me more about your range and the target market.
Yeah, well, certainly, you know, there is a place for wearable technology, but you must remember wearable technology or most of communication technology is a disposable item. So if you think of, most people understand phones better. If your phone is up to date for 6 months, you've done better than most. You know, normally they're changing every 6 months, unless you're what, you know, like my kids like to call me a dinosaur, and I try and hang on to mine for 3 or 4 years, but there's no longer kind of relevant or competitive. Now, what we're producing is fine pieces. In fact, our logo for these watches is our legacy, your heritage, and we're certainly producing mechanical works of art. So not only are they beautiful to look at, where possible they actually use our Gemfields gems, but they're also masterpieces in terms of technology, design, etc., and something that we believe the discerning buyer will buy not only to spoil themselves or someone they care about today, but hopefully pass on to generations in the future.
So it's almost an investment. Look, when people think of Fabergé, they think of the iconic X, and business news fiends all know too that the business was in trouble when you took it on. I mean, does this news mean that they're back?
Absolutely. I mean, first of all, the eggs was one part of it. So Fabergé, Carl Fabergé, was known for numerous pieces of jewellery. He was actually quite cutting edge in his day. Not only he was well recognised for the imperial eggs, but he did a bunch of other things. He also did an automaton. The watch that actually won us the award is the peacock egg. And one of his eggs had a little peacock automaton where the egg would open, a little wind-up peacock that was mechanical would be inside. And this was really inspiration. So there are numerous components. And, yeah, I think it's a great brand, and bringing a brand into a competitive segment is not easy. But I really do think we're heading in the right direction, and we can certainly see it in terms of sales, designs, et cetera, demand coming from not only customers, but more and more of the larger multi-brand stores looking to bring Fabergé into their stores as well.
So how does this reset the way that the luxury world and the markets will view Fabergé in terms of the sales and the target markets that you were talking about?
Well, you know, in short, the award per se, there's many components behind it. The award is just part of it. But, you know, some of the analysts were talking to me this morning, and I said to them, you know, the reality is winning an award like this for many of the other watch brands has pretty much been similar to an actor winning an Oscar. When an actor wins an Oscar, they're able to quadruple the amount of money they can demand for their coming films. And it's very much the same. There are a number of brands where, having won this award, all of a sudden just gain recognition. The investment value of the watches goes up considerably, but so does demand. So it's very important, but it's not on its own. It needs to be tied into marketing, distribution, continuous design. And with a very young, up-and-coming, and the ethos of Gemfields, which is very empowering, I'm very certain that this is just the beginning, and the world will see more and more of this going forward.
A quick reminder for our viewers, your target markets, where are you looking to market these masterpieces?
Well, Fabergé, you know, Gemfields sells product. We're a mining company that markets. We sell our product to a number of jewelers around the world throughout the segment. So some of our product will go to the entry-level stores, some to the high street, some to the high end, and so on. So we certainly don't look to compete with our own customers, and that's exactly why we've acquired Fabergé. We're seeing Fabergé to target it at the very high end to drive change, to drive appreciation and exclusivity of our key product, which is our wonderful gems. And so our current distribution, we have company stores in Geneva, in London, in New York, and then we've got wholesale outlets in various other places around the world, including Australia, Kiev, et cetera, et cetera. But it's always going to be exclusive. So the Fabergé, the people who look for Fabergé will be people who are very discerning, appreciate exclusivity, something with investment value, and will actually come and seek out the stores. We never intend to be a brand that has a store on every high street, in every big city, in every country of the world. That's where many of our other customers will be, and we'll support them. So Fabergé is really at the pinnacle of luxury.
So a global outlook, but with some real exclusivity to it. Look, well, congratulations again for the award. It's been great catching up. Thanks, Ian.
It's a pleasure. Thank you so much.